Welcome back to our vlog on Botswana, where it's currently winter. While our friends and family in Europe and North America are now at the peak of summer, we are at the coldest time of the year. Because Botswana lies in the southern hemisphere, the seasons are switched around. Winter here doesn't mean snowfall or extremely low temperatures. This is still Africa after all. But it does get quite cold, especially at night. In the early mornings, temperatures can be around zero, and we have to dress warmly. Days are shorter too. It's often still dark when we're heading to work in the mornings. And most buildings are not properly insulated and lack central heating, so it gets quite cold inside. During the day, it warms up quite a bit, and you can have a 30 degree temperature difference between day and night. Botswana's desert-like climate makes the country very dry at this time of the year, and all the greenery has changed into shades of brown and orange. The water level in the rivers and lakes have also dropped significantly since the beginning of the year. During one of our recent weekends, we went for a boat ride along the Mtukudzi River, close to Gaborone. The trees were visibly changing color here, which was quite a nice sight. The river is known for the many crocodiles and is nicknamed the Crocodile Ponds. We indeed spotted several of them along the river bank. There were also many different birds around. For my birthday last month, we went to climb Botswana's highest peak in the town of Mtukudzi. The area here is quite hilly and stands out from the mostly flat geography in the rest of the country. Mtukudzi Hill is about 1500 meters high, but the surrounding elevation is already about 1000 meters above sea level, so it's not a very tall mountain. However, the climb up there was quite a challenge. There were no paths at all, and we basically had to scramble up through thick bush and thorny plants. But in the end, we made it to the top. Afterwards, we heard that there is some superstition around the hill, and many locals avoid it. Apparently, people have disappeared on it in the past, and the hill is now considered to be haunted. We made it out alive though. During our first few months in Botswana, at the start of this year, the COVID situation seemed to be under control fairly well. Compared to many other countries in the world, the number of infections were low and social gatherings were a common thing. Both of our jobs have brought us in touch with a nice group of colleagues and friends, which we regularly hang out with. However, in the last month or so, the COVID situation has suddenly spiraled out of control in Botswana. The Delta variant of the virus has spread from South Africa and has been causing a huge spike in infections and deaths. Although there's no real lockdown in place, some extra measures have been implemented. Schools have been closed and Tiana has been teaching from home. To travel between regions, you require a travel permit. And checkpoints have been set up at all the roads at the edges of the regions. Permit is obtainable through an app on your phone. But the number of permits is restricted, and during public holidays, the app is shut down completely. Alcohol is banned again as well, both to minimize social gatherings as to keep hospital beds free for COVID patients. Drinking and driving is a bit of a problem here, and accidents occur often. Vaccines are still not widely available in Botswana, and only a small portion of the people have been vaccinated. Even compared to other African nations, Botswana is quite behind and will remain exposed to the virus until sufficient vaccines have been obtained. Let's hope vaccines will be here soon. For now, we can only wait.